provide the service or the facilities that it could. And
one who a lot is expected from on the day. JC now look to extricate themselves.
Oh, a burst of speed.
This looks good now. Nicholas Scott. Initiative numbers. They come forward once again. Hardware. Solid challenge there. The big number 20, Andre Powell, coming out of right full back for Jamaica College. I think the crowd has enjoyed what they've seen so far in the first 15 minutes. All the tools and the ingredients to produce such. Philpott trying to produce now for Bridgeport. Back with JC now. Their season is far from over. So too Bridgeport. There's one driven across the park now.
And just looking at him this afternoon, somehow the hard-working man up front.
Bridgeport will look to come away. Andre Powell.
That's a space.
This is Hardware now. This is one on two.
Bad dribble by Hardware on that occasion. Showed the ball to both defenders.
From his opponents. Gets a return. This looks good now. Stets to Glenmuir nil. The defending champions are turning on the styles and the heat.
Big move for Stets.
Clearly.
Continues out. Here comes Bridgeport once again.
2 minutes to be added. Where and
Williams.
Kemar Phillips. Jamaica College is his then that will get the second half on the way. This time they'll be going to the right. Bridgeport in full
pitch for Bridgeport. Now on the left side of the pitch, searching for spaces to attack.
Andre Powell out of the right full back area for Jamaica College. Main Morgan, it is. We'll put this one over for Bridgeport. Had some good intentions. Rossi's one, Old Harbour.
Look how the player to the right is open. They come to the left where Hardware is.
Buckner, now Hardware. And then Gary Winter.
But Buckner had a player wide to his right with no one within 15, 20 yards of him.
JC now. They want to go on the counter. This is Bridgeport now. They look to come forward once again. Schleifer. Gotten so busy since the start of the second half.
Now you have Hardware in the midfield. He's the man with the ball. This is all.
And Stets versus an opponent to be decided.
And new life to the legs of number 9, Williams.
The number 6, Adrian Crooks, is also back on the park. He was the man who took that hit in the face, which led to the red card for Theo Campbell in minute number. We make it. JC. Reminding you, they're down to 9. Two players sent off.
The longer the game goes, is the more they'll be exposed. And here comes Jamaica College
again.
Here
they come again now.
Playing
this
smart.
Is another attack brewing. Andre Powell has it now.
And their support and goes up around the ground.
86 minutes. We're going to toss it back to Master Control now for the cash bot draw. And we'll be back. Whipped up into attack mode. Thrusted through now for Bridgeport. Can this be the magical moment?
Oh, cleared away.
It won't.
Bounces into touch. Jamaica College just getting away by the skin of their teeth there.
St. Elizabeth Technical leading their contest by 2-1. We look back at Bridgeport there. The attack a short while ago. They
came into the game with an injury and then Williams got tired and had to be relieved. Hardware is the next main.
It's each way to decide the second semi-final in the Manning Cup for 2010 between Bridgeport in red going to the left now. The defenders blocks. JC now. What will they do? Can they mount the counter-attack once again?
On again.
Walker has it now. This is Walker.
Defensive third. The ball is banged back upfield to start them over. Hardware with the ball on the left.
3.5 minutes to go.
The defense
in extra. Those 7.5 minutes. The second period of extra time. Middle of the park. Jay Lindsay for Bridgeport.
Bad decisions, both of them. but since they have been down to nine, they have looked much better.
Stets have won their game 2-1. Rossi's have prevailed 3-1 over Old Harbour. The very latest coming in from the Da Costa Cup. Messam now for Jamaica College towards the back. Oh, that would have been spectacular.
Yes, Spencer.
That could have been the winner for Jamaica College.
And that's why I said to you, it's not over until it's over. Because look at that chance. Again, Jamaica College showing the smarts. Holding up the ball on the left. Slipping it to Messam on the right. And this is number 11, Messam. A wonderful cross. Pulls the goalkeeper. Flapping at it. And the arriving player got a wide open goal. Could not turn it under the bar. Went over. And just for anybody listening, Spencer, just in case.
Walker! 105 minutes without a goal and then penalty kicks.
Oh, he did.
Johnson.
Hey, for us.
Jermaine Morgan on the right foot, it's Seb. This is Theo Campbell then. For Jamaica College.
Well done.
Again, backs off just a couple steps. Hardware.
Oh, lucky.
Nicholas Scott, right footed.
Excellent.
It's there. Jamaica College out of Old Hope Road into the Manning Cup final for 2010. They will take on Waterford for the chance to be crowned Corporate Area Schoolboy Football Champions. And he gets the 2010 Manning Cup final underway at the office. Jamaica College up against Waterford in possession now. Romaine Gibbons. Waterford get some purchase on that one as well. What about the JC defensive thrust now? They have an assignment to conduct. Pulling the strings, threading the needle for Jamaica College in the middle. Then at the other end, you've got Andre McFarlane and Britton and company.
Seem to be disturbed by it, but possibly I could ask the supporters to desist it. It will interfere with the players from time to time and the officials.
This is Waterford again. He's driving one down the park. McFarlane into the mix quite early.
Offside,
the offside trap in effect. We're getting a fresh update now from Jared Park.
The Russians are coming.
Jared Park must be buzzing now, Clyde.
Yes, definitely.
The stadium is buzzing as well. JC and Waterford trying to whip them into a frenzy. Here comes Jamaica College now. Occasions to pull off a few saves, more so. Mikhail Harrison over Waterford.
Yes.
Here comes Jamaica College again now, trying to raid enemy land. Doing quite well so far. Andre Powell, Mikhail Harrison back in the Waterford lineup now for this final. Did not play in the semi-final. Dowell and Ian Forbes, the manager of Jamaica College. Been the manager for a number of years now, Ian Forbes. He's really supported this team.
And both senior professionals in their field.
Oh, yes.
And far. And no goals yet. Three attempts from Waterford. No goals yet for them.
Andre Powell has it now for Jamaica College. And Theodore Thomas was in there as well.
Another sniff by this Waterford team. Very simple. Not as decorated and as classic in their ball move.
Off. But how many times have we seen teams are taking the lead on the stroke of halftime? I think to hear the whistle. There we go. The end of the first half in the Manning Cup final here at the compared to when we came in for the third place playoff, which got underway at one. Here we go then.
Definitely, and a gentle breeze just
needed a dark blue shirt there. The test of the custodian. Here they come again now.
Oh! Could not get control of it, and the ball lobbed over the crossbar.
An intelligent little player. This is Ashani Walker. Here he is again now, middle of the park. What will he do? This time he goes to the right. Get some support over there now. Touching one forward. Andre Powell. For St. James High in their semi-final at Jarrett Park. JC and Waterford still in a deadlock now. This is Jamaica College now. This looks really promising now. Andre Powell has it now. Weaving his way and slicing the drums. banged about in the grandstand. Spectators had, especially those from JC, have had their temperature.
Player for
Jamaica College have brought on Jason Moulton, making their first change of the match. Waterford have their work cut out now. They've got to get back from two goals down. JC will be ensuring that they direct
in the last 15, 20 minutes, throwing here to Waterford.
Here they come now. Can they pull back one?
No.
No, they can't.
Cleared for a corner.
Now they try to do so. Thomas. Like the venom with which they came into this match had been knocked out. They were probably barking in a moderate tone, but certainly weren't biting at all. Has some support to his right. Driven into danger once again. And Harrison, for the umpteenth time, even though he had been beaten on three occasions, came forward, made a good catch. Taking up. That's it. Jamaica College out of Old Hope Road, our cock-a-hoop. Their first Manning Cup crown in 3 years and their 21st in the history of the competition. 3-0 over Waterford, the first time finalist. Look at the celebrations. This is joy unconfined for the boys in dark blue.
Season, the schoolboy football season. As we get on the way here, Neil Hardware can take a shot from distance because he has that powerful left foot, decides for the delicate pass instead. Didn't really work out too tough for Shevon James, who had some difficulty keeping it in play. In the end, it's a throw to find Kemar Prince, who's now on the left. This is Andre Powell playing a little. Oh my goodness, he couldn't get much closer than that as it came off the post.
The penalty area, and apart from Hardware, who got inside and had a good look, but didn't take a good or a well directed shot.
We're playing it over to the right hand side and finding Andre Powell. Powell trying to get by his second player but did eventually. Now he gets it back from Campbell. Powell with the cross. They managed to come away with it. Now here is Daniil Hardware.
Whistle goes for half time. Side of Jamaica College infield.
They have to do some defending now, though. Nicholas Scott has it. Now, Powell. Powell played it upfield to Campbell. Campbell running back and intercepting. A beautiful move. And still couldn't get there.
Means you have the one. Getting the thrust of their attack or their team play.
Powell trying to keep it in play and does so. One of the goals of the season, and what a time to score it, making it 3-1 for your team in the Walker Cup final.
Oh, don't.
That they're capturing the corporate era double, the Manning Cup and the Walker Cup.
To something, I think he was also motivated by what happened with him last year in regards to Issa, and wanted to do well and do extremely.
Taken up now by Rossiz. Ramon Foster, good challenge. JC have it once again now. They want to come forward. Andre Powell, middle of the park. Looks like either Ramai. Good challenge coming in. Andre Powell wants to take charge now for Jamaica College. He does. He normally takes very, very good penalties, I tell you. JC have it again. Andre Powell now, the right full back. JC once again now. Walker has some options. Andre Powell makes himself available. This time he goes for the back door now. And again from
high over the crossbar.
Yes, that one sat up nicely. Anthony Walker now. My word, he has been quiet so far.
Off possession, score, and score often.
Absolutely. Strike while the iron is hot.
Corner kick, short.
Ramon Foster now with the delivery towards the back door.
Oh, cleared off.
Very,
line.
Very close.
At goal within the last minute and hopefully coming out of their slumber and answering the call. Dango winning a corner and then coming more into the game. A more level playing field now in the last. Seems to be okay.
In the final analysis, Andre Powell now. He goes to the right. Signal coming from the fourth official now, Christopher Forrest.
So walk on the run. Walk on the run.
Move closer then towards the interval.
Oh.
What was that? Valdin let just about satisfied. And he's ready now and he says, let's get it on now.
In the first 45 minutes, Rossi's.
Walker just taking that one down momentarily. Jamaica College again showing that sense of urgency. Touched forward by Andre Powell.
Tied there, shown on the face of the Rossi's bench. And that one, again, just not getting the balls in the right attacking areas or to foot or to teammate. Not
on the back. Here they come once again now. Counter-attack is on in no uncertain terms. Andre Powell screaming out of his rightful back position.
Looking it around.
This is JC again now. This is well done. Teasing delivery. And that's
by Graham.
So we look at the build up down the far side once again. Theo Campbell and company, and look at Nicholas Scott there. Acrobatic and all. Wonderful effort. Gave in to that request. Doesn't think he will stay on next season. Let's wait and see. Because he said it in 2007 when they won it. Said he would relocate, would go overseas once again. But he remained up there at Old Hope Road. Very solid structure up there. They're solid at the back now. This is Ashani Walker, solid in front as well. Theo Campbell.
Oh, back across the face of the goal. Here it is, Ashani Walker. Constructed, 1-2. Powell, back in his part.
Leaves one man for dead, well done. Good support, arriving. And that got Brian Brown. That wasn't a good penalty at all.
No, poorly taken.
No proper technique. Walker now slots it through. Also getting ready to make a change as well. They will be bringing up
from that to continue trying to get a goal or two here. And Jamaica College, you have been warned not just once,
but far. But if the scoreline remains as it is, it's JC who will travel down to the second city. Lamont Graham may just be having the final kick of this game. That's it. Valdin Legister bring.
Well, this game lasts for 90 minutes. Just be patient.
His first touch on the ball, but now it comes to Woozencroft. Woozencroft plays it inside to Walker, and it's cleared out of the edge by both teams.
Yep.
As we see and take another look at the run by Walker, it was good defending by Andre Powell, backtracking and clearing it outside the 18, out of the 18-yard box. Versees trying to get out of their own half, but can't do so at the moment because this is Powell playing it wide to Prince. One touch across, looking for Walker. Finds him, eventually, plays it back wide.
He needed to have caused some problems by putting a little bit more to the penalty spot.
Oh, here's Walker. Mm. Oh, but Powell is back there doing some crucial defending once more. And it's Walker. Comes out as far as Shamal Thomas. Thomas feeds it high at the back post. Touched inside by Powell. Looking for Walker. Now the shot by Scott.
Oh, rather quickly. Look at that. Quickly on in. It presented a lot of problem for the... if he had not taken those legs away, it would have been dangerous.
Goals from there, in particular, with the right foot. Well, he says play on.
Well.
Carl Tyrell. And they do play on. Powell. Powell
back to Walker. Back to Powell.
Fighting spirit.
Well,
perhaps he knew more about than he did. He knew that
it was ambitious, to say the least.
Was that goal? And I think he just
pumps it up through to Wozencroft, who couldn't control. It goes the other way now.
Oh, they've given the ball away again. Jamaica College wins possession again in the middle.
Powell has it.
Makes no sense, really.
An all game, but he lost that battle. And Israel sees history has been made at Jarrett Park. The small pocket of supporters over on the far side will make a whole lot of noise.
And they are.
Jamaica College